everybody, Dr. Janine Krause here. I am going to talk about ways to get your posture in check so that you can get rid of your low back pain. Did you know that the fourth leading cause of death in humans is sedentarism? Why? Well, we sit at our desks all day long, we end up tightening up the front of our bodies, and we don't strengthen the back side of our body. So then we end up weak, we end up with illnesses, we fall, all kinds of things start happening. And so I'm here to show you a couple of different tricks that you can do to work to prevent low back pain, especially if you have a job where you're sedentary. And so first things first, right in the front here, we have a big muscle. It's a combination of a muscle. It has two parts. It's called the iliopsoas, but it has the psoas, which comes from T12, so this middle part of your belly coming down and then attaches on the inside here of your groin at the lesser trochanter. So a little bit of anatomy and physiology for you. And then we have a muscle called the iliacus that's kind of on the inside of our big wing hip bones here. And that joins the psoas major and attaches down at your lesser trochanter. And so those guys are always stuck in this kind of position when you're sitting. They become nice and strong, but unfortunately, they get so strong that they pull your back out of alignment, so your spine. They also can pull your pelvis out of alignment as well. And so a lot of us are sitting in this type of position, and we might be leaning one way or the other depending on what we need for work, or depending on that we're not even paying attention to what we're doing. Then the other thing is that we oftentimes have this kind of position with our back swayed out. Now, that's not so good for your low back and for your pelvis. The idea here is to tuck your tailbone under. So tuck that tail in. Also, great time to tighten up your abs, just so you can punch those abs. So like if someone wants to punch you, you got it. You're not gonna fall. So tightening up your abs and tucking your tailbone under helps to put your pelvis in a good position. Now, the other thing is that if we're sitting all day and these hip flexors are super tight, well, guess what? Our glutes and our hamstrings become weak. So one way to work on that is to work on squeezing those glutes. And so I'm gonna do a little butt squeeze. I don't know if you can see this here. Working on trying to squeeze things and over squeeze it so you can kind of see with my demo. Oftentimes I have people tighten up their glutes as tight as they can, just squeeze in those butt cheeks as much as they can. Almost like if you put a potato chip there. Well, maybe not because you might crunch it, but we'll have it holding a pencil there between those two butt cheeks. So we hold that there and we squeeze it for about 30 seconds and then we let go. Or what you can do is you can just keep squeezing. You can like give yourself a little beat, like and squeeze in your butt cheek. I do this all day long. Why? Because, hey, it's kind of fun actually, but it helps to tighten those glutes. Now, another thing you can do is work on tightening your hamstrings up and strengthening those guys. We'll show that in another demo. But one thing to think about here is that from the waist down, this area, this is our foundation. These are our pillars. This is our strength. It's what prevents us from falling. It's what prevents us from slipping. It's also what holds our body up. And if these guys aren't strong, then it sets us up for a lot of issues as we get older. And so it's key to keep yourself strong in the lower half of the body. Now, I'm not discounting the upper half, but nevertheless, just want to put it out there that the stronger the lower body is, the better you're going to be off in the future. And so also the better you're going to be off with your low back. Why? Because low back strength is about your core. It's also about a perfect balance between your hip flexors and your glutes. You don't want one or the other stronger. Why? Because they're going to pull back and forth, and they're going to pull that pelvis out of alignment, and then they're going to cause your low back to be out of alignment. And a lot of times we'll have that back pain right up here, but in all reality, our issue is more in the pelvis. And so I'm going to exaggerate it a little bit. See how my back's kind of like this? A lot of people are walking around doing that. Why? Because our bellies are hanging over and they're kind of pulling things. Tuck that tailbone under. I know it looks kind of funny with me exaggerating it. Roll those shoulders back, and now you've got the perfect posture. Pull that chin back. Now you're working on neck pain prevention, back pain prevention, so thoracic mid-back pain prevention, and your low back pain prevention. So, moral of the story is, tuck your tailbone under, do some butt squeezes to try to balance out that tension you create in your hip flexors when you're sitting down all day. And if you can, and I highly encourage it, out of every hour that you are awake during the day, try to stand up and move at least 10, 20 minutes or so. Maybe get up and do some marches, lunges, little squats, whatever you can do to keep you moving throughout the day. Thanks for watching!